Since the time of the Founding Fathers, dark forces have been preying on America. As the fight against these vampires continued, a secret organization has trained people with remarkable skills. The agent's duty is to protect ordinary people from the forces of evil.
Chester will be none too chatty with his guts sprayed all over a train carriage.
I know how to shape an explosion, Edgar.
It's coming. Wait for it.
About the bridge.
Barrow could suck my dick. He's the Secretary of War, not the Secretary of Bridges. Let's go have a look-see. I go high.
Nah, it's not that bad. I can make it.
Let's give it a try.
What's that sound?
Stop whining and start moving!
You smell that?
Shit!
Born 1857, 1864, 1881. Arranged in order of vintage like fine wines. All dead.
Fuck.
Boy, you better make all this worth our time, Chester.
Yeah.
boy.
That felt good.
More ticks.
What happened?
Looks like you could use a hand.
Worst damn barbecue ever.
Hey, boyo, guess who's riding in first class and responsible for the biggest delivery in gathering history?
Remember when the dream of attending the gathering was just that? Wishful thinking.
but I am on my way, soon to be hobnobbing with the creme de la creme. The oldest, the wisest, the most powerful. This is where it begins. If I play this right, in 100 years, I'll be the one being catered to by human douchebags like you. That's it for now. I must bid you adieu. There's still much to do, and I can't louse this up. Yours truly, Chester, the Catering King.
I can smell you, Chess, you lousy skunk.
I'm taking it.
Join you? Now I'm pissed!
Then let's get that son of a bitch!
Young Rentier, still on your father's leash, I see.
Heard you were on your way to the gathering, Chess. What's this? Catering?
Why, I have no idea what you're...
That big shiny ball out there is no good for your sensitive skin.
The sun's not to know what they'll do to me.
Fun game. Let's test that theory.
No, no, Richard, stop! Belmontville! The gathering's in Belmontville!
Excellent choice, Chester. And since you're feeling so damn helpful, we're gonna be needing a guide. Consider it a promotion, dipshit.
Belmontville's a long way from the manor. We're on a clock here.
We've been hunting DeBono for 3 months. What's another few hours?
Have it your way. But your father's gonna have your ass as an ashtray if we don't make that presentation.
You're retired. What's he gonna do? Fire you?
Belmontville Mines, huh? We're gonna be walking blind into a damn maze.
And if our tick friend here is telling the truth, DeBono's gonna be right in the middle of it.
I don't think I'm in a position to lie, do you?
That's the spirit, Chester. Now you lift those fancy illusions and who knows? Maybe you'll make it out of this after all.
The glamour! Even I have my limitations, Mr. Gravener.
You want a limitation? How about walking around without a head?
Crawling with familiars. No question.
And where do you think you're going?
Judging by that tone of yours, sounds like I'm making sure Fancy Pants here doesn't make a run for it.
In broad daylight. That's why we need familiars. I'm starting to question your qualifications for this job.
Those ass-licking... Tick lovers should be shot on sight. What the hell. Maybe we can play with dynamite out here, too. Right, Jess? I'll make you a new waistcoat.
I don't believe my tailor would like that.
See? You're bonding already.
Eat me! That gathering won't find itself, you know? Move it.
You know, the cat is right there in front of you.
Oh, shut up. I told you my sight's not recovered after the change.
Hey, so you're telling me it's not the blues?
Family of Calvert. Oh, another tick wannabe. Well, that's not gonna happen.
I'm gonna hang your head on a wall! Target practice!
Smells of ticks. Gathering must be close by.
Okay.
fucking maze. Gotta be a way out, though. Yeah, that looks about right. I'll bet my last dime to Bono's here somewhere.
Dead end. Great. Huh? You seeing this too?
Take it off.
Mr. Rentier, on a first date? What do you take me for?
You're right. Maybe a little lighting to set the mood.
No, no need. I see it now. Of course. The glamour. I'm on it.
Today, Chester.
Please. I need to concentrate. It's not that easy to sever the illusion from its source.
What's the source?
You don't want to know.
Sanguis Eternus.
I'll take the explosives, you get to Bono.
Is this about the bridge?
It's not about the bridge.
Got the damn train, didn't I?
Wretchings!
Thank you.
share of tech architecture, but that, that's something.
It's hard to compete against a species that keeps on growing and advancing with their technology, creating new and more dangerous weapons of war and other engineering marvels. As I see it, the real struggle is nature versus technology, instinct versus genius. We have allowed those naturally subordinate to us to transform themselves from prey into predators. If we don't alter this trajectory, eventually they will murder us all.
Thank you.
We are a unique species, brothers and sisters. We are not bred. We are not born. We come to life when we accept the gift of change. Our powers are many, and they have served us well. The art of glamour has given us safety through secrecy, but I am afraid we are becoming the victims of progress. Sooner or later, human technology will find a way to see past our illusions. They will expose and demonize us and make us their ultimate enemy. Inevitably, we will become their inferiors.
Jesus, it's huge. When did they build this? And how?
Ah!
Yeah. Must be the entrance. Looks even bigger up close. Well, let's crash their little party.
We consider ourselves proud hunters, predators. But that pride sometimes prevents us from growing as a species. Internal divisions have weakened us. Our numbers dwindle while their numbers grow. But it's not too late. We can still survive, but to do so, we must be ready to adapt. We cannot be too proud to evolve. Secrecy is lifted, we won't stand a chance. We might be more powerful, but they will crush us with their numbers. Listen to the voice of reason. There is a thin line between being a survivor and being...
Enough. Your alliance thirst for all out war with the humans endangers us all. Peace of Navano. Without the sheep.
The wolves go hungry, yes. But the day is coming when the sheep will outwit the wolves. Haven't you been watching, brother? The humans have harnessed the power of steam and lightning, and they grow mighty. If our hubris allows us to grow fat and lazy in the shadows, they will soon have the power to hunt us down like dogs.
And so you propose war.
War suggests there is a chance we might lose. I propose we strike with my new asset. We can control the change. Reclaim the Sanguisuja's rightful place at the top of the food chain.
Control the change? Are you mad? Even suggesting such a thing is blasphemy.
Dominic, brother, these are blasphemous times. While my methods may very well be at variance with our tradition, I can tell you one thing. If we don't adapt, we will perish.
Enough. I will not allow you and your bastard breed to lead us into annihilation. Peter Davala, for the high crime of conspiracy against your own kind, I sentence you and your line to the true death.
We had to try, Felicity Migara. Our work will be a lot easier if we can help them understand. If we can't...
Then... we... force them to!
Ooh!
Think you could have brought a bigger knife?
Some people get a gold watch when they retire. I got Susan here.
Should have asked him how to get out of here.
Too late. He won't be of any use for a month or two. Wait, what about Chester?
Well, what are you gonna do?
Now that is how you shape an explosion. Damn, we're late.
Now, at least we won't be going back to the manor empty-handed. That's a new way to spend taxpayers' money.
James Harrow. The people's hero. I heard the White House sends him golden toilet paper. Long as he keeps the presidential ass clear of tick trouble. Feed him well. We've got a lot of ground to cover tonight.
You're not staying for the presentation? The whole institute is in town.
I'll pass on the corporate backpatting session. I don't need another retirement lecture. Here, take this to your father before it wakes up and starts cursing us all to high hell.
Great, so I'll just tell him you've traded killing vampires for swilling cheap bourbon?
Tell him whatever you want.
Fine, skip the presentation. But you ain't getting away from a final drink with me afterwards.
Home sweet home.